The fund has stepped up efforts to ensure that employers with large groups of workers comply with the new provisions of the NSSF Act. NSSF today unveiled a partnership with the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development to effectively implement this.
Even in agriculture, if we intervene as a fund and cover, and so the farmer makes more money, then that farmer will save with NSSF. And one of the things we are doing now is, as we begin to look at creating jobs, we've got a program called High Innovator, we've got another one, Livelihood, where people have been trained and they're staying in the villages.
Minister Betty Amongi reaffirmed her ministry's support to the fund.
It's what leads country into the middle income status and development. So when you sit there and do all this, you are not only saving for the old age, you are saving to support the economy. But we make sure that whatever investment is undertaken with money collected is safe to make sure that when you retire, your money is intact. So that's the important aspect.
Provided for actions such as employer-employee registration, staff collaboration updates, and in cases of non-compliance, discussions towards an accommodating payment arrangement. Updating these measures will assist in circumventing substantial penalties.
NSSF aims to register over 1 million new members from an estimated 50,000 employers under the categories provided for by the amended law. Story by Jelet Namwaya for the news.